After more than 2 years and 9 test flights, critics claim that Starship has yet to live up to expectations, arguing that SpaceX has overpromised and underdelivered. They describe a slow pace of progress and disappointing results. But are these criticisms justified? What's behind this, and how should SpaceX address the issues? Let's dive deeper. In today's episode of NR Studio, we'll get to the bottom of it. For aerospace enthusiasts, few experiences can match the thrill of watching a rocket program make progress. Each launch brings a flood of emotions, and the transformation from setback to achievement is a source of endless intrigue and excitement. Some observers, however, take a more pragmatic, results-oriented approach. From their perspective, a project is judged by its clear, measurable outcomes. In this light, Starship's journey has raised eyebrows. The project has yet to reach orbit after 2 years of testing, has yet to successfully land either stage, and has failed to deliver concrete progress toward a mission to the Moon or Mars. Critics have emphasized these facts, not only focusing on the lack of major milestones, but also highlighting perceived inconsistencies within the Starship program itself, particularly regarding its design philosophy, thrust-to-mass ratio, and Starship payload capacity. SpaceX frequently touts Starship as the most powerful rocket ever made, a claim that may be true in theory. However, there is still some doubt about whether the rocket has actually achieved its full capabilities. The Raptor 2 engines are designed to produce about 230 tons of thrust, and when combined with the 33 engines on the Super Heavy boosters, the potential liftoff thrust could reach about 7,590 tons. The upcoming Raptor 3 engines are projected to increase that number even further, potentially reaching estimates between 9,000 and 10,000 tons. These are impressive numbers, suggesting that Starship could be the most capable launch system on Earth. However, SpaceX has not confirmed in practice that the rocket has achieved this level of performance, raising questions about its actual payload capacity. The V1 version of Starship was originally anticipated to be capable of carrying up to 100 tons into orbit. However, real-world assessments suggest the rocket may only be capable of carrying about 50 tons. The V2 variant was expected to carry 150 to 200 tons, but appears to be capable of carrying closer to 100 tons. This discrepancy has raised concerns that SpaceX may have overestimated the rocket's capabilities, leading to skepticism about the long-term viability of its ambitious mission. The ambition to travel to the Moon and Mars faces significant challenges, particularly in terms of propulsion and vehicle mass. Starship, developed by SpaceX, is extremely heavy. Its dry mass is estimated at around 200 tons for the Super Heavy booster alone, with an additional 100 tons for Starship itself. SpaceX has recognized that the overall weight of the vehicle exceeds ideal parameters, leading to a design that prioritized weight reduction for each subsequent model. However, the effectiveness of these modifications remains uncertain. Efforts to lighten Starship have presented new problems. SpaceX has chosen to streamline various internal systems by eliminating components they consider non-essential. While this strategy may contribute to weight savings, it also increases the risk of failure. For example, in the fourth test, the V2 version's fuel tank showed consistent flight problems. One failure caused the mission to be aborted before launch, while another resulted in a leak that caused the vehicle to lose control on subsequent flights. Furthermore, critical protection systems from previous iterations have been removed, likely exacerbating engine reliability issues. Given these challenges, SpaceX has attempted to restore several safety features, such as fire suppression systems and structural reinforcements. However, these additions come at the cost of added weight, and the increased reliability has not been proven convincingly. Additionally, there is ongoing discussion about the materials used in Starship's construction. SpaceX's choice to use stainless steel was based on its favorable properties, including durability, thermal resistance, cost-effectiveness, and ease of fabrication. However, this decision has drawn criticism, as many argue that stainless steel contributes significantly to the rocket's weight, reducing payload efficiency. Heavier materials require more powerful engines, which can lead to increased wear and a higher chance of failure. Some experts have advocated a return to carbon fiber, a lighter alternative that can reduce stress on the engines by reducing the vehicle's structural mass. This engineering dilemma is further complicated by the program's performance history. With the exception of the last two anticipated flights in 2024, most of the test missions have failed. In many cases, previous problems were only resolved only to have new ones emerge, indicating that various systems are still not fully operational. The Starship program has been a huge expense, spending billions of dollars over the past 2 years through 9 test flights and the construction of extensive ground support infrastructure. The current state of SpaceX Starship program marks a significant departure from the affordable launch solution the company initially promised. Several critical issues have emerged about Starship, prompting discussion about the validity of these arguments. Do you find these arguments to be sound? We invite you to share your thoughts in the comments section, either by answering yes or no, and feel free to elaborate on your reasons. In my opinion, I strongly disagree with the criticisms leveled at Starship. It is only natural that new rocket systems face substantial technical challenges. This is not unique to SpaceX. It is true of all aerospace organizations involved in the development of next-generation launch vehicles. The increased visibility of Starship's challenges can be attributed in large part to SpaceX's more aggressive approach to development, which contrasts with the more cautious strategies used by traditional aerospace entities. Many established institutions tend to take things slower, carefully analyzing data, identifying problems, and making necessary adjustments before moving on to the next flight. For example, it took NASA more than 2 years to publicly acknowledge problems with its Orion spacecraft, while United Launch Alliance took about 9 months between its first two Vulcan flights. Ariane 6 has had a development gap that has stretched to 8 months, and Blue Origin, after its launch in January, still has no firm timetable for its next mission. In contrast, SpaceX has championed a philosophy of constant testing, rapid iteration, and learning from failure. If not for regulatory constraints imposed by the FAA or ongoing legal challenges from environmental advocacy groups, Starship could have completed many more flights than its current 9. This progressive approach has led SpaceX to groundbreaking milestones, including an ambitious attempt to capture a Super Heavy booster using its Mechazilla arm, a maneuver unprecedented in aerospace history. It begs the question of whether any other space company would dare to undertake such a challenge. For skeptics of SpaceX's development model, it's worth reflecting on the evolution of the Falcon family of rockets. SpaceX has applied the same philosophy of incremental innovation and rigorous testing to advance from the Falcon 1 to the Falcon 9, and finally to the Falcon Heavy. Today, Falcon rockets dominate the global launch sector, renowned for their frequency, cost efficiency, and reusability. The level of performance achieved by the Falcon series would have seemed nearly unattainable just a decade ago, suggesting that these results come from a willingness to embrace innovation and iteration rather than a traditional, risk-averse engineering mindset. There's every reason to believe that Starship could embark on a similar trajectory. SpaceX's vision for Starship is undeniably ambitious, and its potential for the future of space exploration is enormous. In a groundbreaking move for the future of space exploration, a leading company is setting its sights on an unprecedented launch cadence, targeting as many as 25 missions a year. The ambitious plan calls for a total of 400 flights over 4 years, with aspirations for multiple daily launches to coincide with opportunities to travel to Mars. These numbers are not only bold, they are significant. Establishing a sustained human presence on the Moon or Mars will require thousands of flights to transport equipment, develop infrastructure, deploy crews, and deliver cargo. You know, current rocket systems like SLS, New Glenn, and Vulcan are unlikely to match this scale of operations this decade or the next. Starship stands out as the only system in active development designed with high operational throughput in mind. Its architecture supports the frequencies critical to future missions, while emphasizing full reusability as a core principle. SpaceX's decision to use stainless steel as its primary structural material is a strategic one, despite its critics. Stainless steel has several benefits. It is strong, cost-effective, heat-resistant, and easy to work with. More importantly, these properties make them well-suited for anticipated autonomous operations on Mars, where the manufacture of replacement parts or complete spacecraft may need to be done on site. The combination of methane and liquid oxygen, or methalox engines, fits into this vision, as these fuels can be produced using in-situ resource utilization, ISRU, techniques on Mars. In terms of feasibility for deep space missions, the combination of stainless steel and methalox positions Starship as a more practical option than any carbon fiber rocket. While carbon fiber may provide some weight advantages, It poses challenges in terms of cost, manufacturability, and scalability for mass production. With deliberate design choices, SpaceX is laying the groundwork for large-scale Starship manufacturing, enabling rapid turnaround times between flights. One bolder strategy involves landing directly onto the launch tower using an innovative system known as Mechazilla. While complex, this method could facilitate unmatched launch rates and significantly lower cost per launch. The performance metrics of this system may not be readily apparent at this time, but they will be as the technology advances. Compared to existing rockets like the SLS, which cost billions of dollars per launch with only a handful of flights per decade, Starship offers a transformative alternative, potentially enabling hundreds or even thousands of flights at a fraction of the cost. Such scalability positions Starship as a revolutionary force in aerospace technology. Critics often claim that the system is fundamentally flawed and argue for a return to conventional designs and materials. While there's no denying that innovation carries risks, avoiding change out of fear can stifle progress. Clinging to outdated methods risks missing out on advances that could propel humanity forward. For those who remain skeptical, developments surrounding Starship invite a reconsideration of its incredible potential in the era of space exploration. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one, and thank you all for your support.